Hello friends, in this video, we are going to build a fact or collapsible component by using HTML and Tailwind CSS only. So let's get started. At the official Tailwind CSS website, click the Get Started button. As you can see, there are multiple ways to integrate Tailwind CSS into our projects. For the sake of simplicity, I will choose the CDN Playground, copy the snippets, paste them into the index.html file and create a new file called tailwind.config.js to activate the Tailwind IntelliSense. Set the body background with a bit of shady by adding BG Slate 100 and set the text color gray 600. Add the container class for wrapping the elements and set margin left and right to auto with MX auto and some space with padding 4. We'll be using the tails elements to toggle the invisible content natively without JavaScript. And then add some random content within a div and a paragraph. Next, add a visible text by using the summary tag above the content, let's say how do I get reference. And this is how the unstyled elements look like. Okay. Let's make the details element prettier by adding classes of BG White, Shadow, and Rounded. Now let's focus on the summary elements. First, let's remove this tiny little triangle icon by adding a class of ListNone. And then set the display with Flex, FlexWrap, and ItemCenter, because I want to add a new toggle icon beside the title. So let's create a simple toggle icon with a div and classes of border 8, border transparent, border left gray 600 and margin left 2. Wrap this toggle icon with a div and classes of flex, width of 10, item center and justify center. We also need to wrap the title with a tag. H3 will be ideal. Add classes of flex, flex1, p4, and font semi-bold. So now the title has a dynamic width, and the icon has a fixed width that will always stay at the center of its parent element. Set the default state of details element with open, so we will have a better view while styling the invisible content area. Add p4 at the div. Go back to the summary element because there are a few things that we need to cover. The first one is the hover state because it's not so clear whether the element is clickable or not. To do this, we need to add a cursor pointer in the summary. Next is the toggle icon. Let's give a different style while the state is open or closed. In Tailwind CSS, to style elements based on the parent state, we can mark it with a group statement. So now, we can change the style for the icon if the state opens with a group open. Let's try border purple 500. As you can see, the icon color now turned purple if the state is open. But this is not what we are going to achieve. Let's change it with rotate 90 and then add transition transform origin left. Now we have a nice transition animation for the toggle icon. Another thing that we need to cover for our component is keyboard accessibility. If we press the tab button on the keyboard, you will see the summary wrapped within an orange outline. Let's say we want to consist the color based on the main website color, which is maybe pink. Add color outline none, focus ring, and focus ring 500. Now the summary has a focus style with a pink color. The focus state also gave the outline color effect on click, which is not appropriate. So let's change it with focus visible so the effect only works while navigating with the keyboard. Give it a try. Now it's working as expected. One more tweak to make it better. I don't know if you can see it. Our detail elements have a rounded corner, but the focus outline is square. let's add rounded at the summary and remove the rounded bottom when the state is open with group open rounded B none and Z index with 1. But Tailwind CSS doesn't have a pre-made style for Z index 1, so we can use arbitrary properties within the opening and closing square bracket with 1. Add relative to make the Z index work. Add details elements with margin bottom 4, so there will be a space if there are multiple details elements. Duplicate details elements. Remove the default open state. Okay, now that we have a nice collapsible element built with HTML and Tailwind CSS only. Okay friends, I think that's all for now. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave a comment below. Last but not least, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you again. Bye bye.